the return of better times. Every dollar possible should be put into circulation. This means either buying the things you desire, purchasing securities, or putting your cash in some strong bank. I'm happy to say that the recent legislation of our government has restored confidence in our banking structure. Hidden dollars are coming out to again draw interest. Dollars like individuals must work if they expect to receive pay. Your dollars can be made to produce income for you with absolutely no effort on your part. Those who need extra income are finding interest received on money deposited in their banks an easy way of getting it. This means the bank can extend more credit to those who require it for new homes, the extending of businesses, and for all worthy enterprises. And thus employment will increase. Detroit is very fortunate in the strength of its present banks, and doubly so now that the government has put its credit behind the banking system of this United States. Make your dollars do their duty. More of them will be easier to get if you keep them at work, either by spending, investing, or depositing them. Sweetie, what do you suppose that these kids of ours are going to turn out to be?
Well, judging from Roy's tendencies now, I imagine he might prove to be an inventor, because anything that he can think of to do odd jobs that he has to do himself will be most welcome. He's a very lazy boy.
You know, that gal Joe of ours, kind of lazy, too. She just takes her clothes and throws them all over the floor.
Oh, but you wait. She'll earn money if she has to ride in a rodeo to hire a maid to pick them up for her. She'll fix that.
Well, that little fella, Jack, you know, he's kind of noisy, and I've got a great hunch for him.
What's that?
Well, you know, down in at our factory this year on the new line, we've got two mufflers on our cars, and we've got a muffler on the intake. I think that that's the way we'll have to put out Jack for the 1933 model.
Well, how about the outtake or something? The exhaust or whatever you call it. You got a muffler for that, too? All right. That's Sally of ours. We have to put her in charge of the complaint department. There may be rice, potatoes, and macaroni every other day for luncheon. It's different, but her complaints are always the same.
Well, she's going to grow up and get over that, too, I'm sure. How about our little Dan?
Oh, he's a little bit clumsy. He goes to pick his sister up, and he knocks her over instead. Time will tell. He'll probably turn out to be graceful. Now, how about the baby?
He may be a real dancer yet, that boy.
Well, maybe.
Well, Marion, you know, she's a funny thing. She's the most determined member of our family, and I'm not accepting either you or myself.
You bet not. What's she going to run?
Well, I think she's going to run the Hudson Motor Car Company.
Probably. But there's a lot of give and take in a big family like this, and they'll have to learn. They will learn.
Well, speaking of giving, do you know that they're the most generous children, I think, that there are in the world?
Well, whenever there's a celebration, a birthday or a Christmas, they certainly prove that they think of others.
Well, they sure are thoughtful.
I think so.
Congratulations on it.
Thank you, David.